Great start to the stream. Thank you very much, Jade.
Good job.
On that note,
we're really going shit.
Can you edit that out?
No.
It's live.
Edit that in.
It's live. Oh my god.
And it's on board for all time.
Good. I'm so glad. Oh, I need to change what the title of the game is and stuff. I'm so good at this. Game.
No, you.
I'm so professional.
You're supposed to give us a countdown.
7, 5, 11, 14, 3, 9, 42, 1. Blast off.
What's the name of the stream? What are we going to call it?
Too many memes spoil the broth.
Why
are you calling it that for? Who's going to watch this?
Fucking nobody, that's what.
That's the whole point of Jin's on streams. Let's make it like
this isn't a Jin's on stream. What are you on about?
Shit, obscure. Technically, it is. It's only Jin's own members participating.
It's only Jin's own members participating.
Oh, so one second,
it's like a Jin's own extension stream. You know, here we go. Anyway, now that all that's done, welcome to this Jin's own stream. I've not got Guild Wars as my current active tab. So there we go.
Oh my god, Rory, what the fuck is wrong?
I know. I'm just trash. I'm absolutely horrible.
Unbelievable.
Trash.
Oh my god. What trash?
So you know where you find trash?
He raise you to the max level.
He's worse. He's even worse than my pronunciation of tramp.
Yeah. Sam, you said it fine there, so...
Tramp.
Stop putting the Australian accent on.
Tramp.
Nah, mate. I don't know what you're on about.
Mate. I want to get a tramp.
I don't want any accents. So I've got my pure tram, bloody accent right here, son.
Oh, man.
Fuck's sake.
Where the fuck are we giving permission to stream? Who the fuck thought this was a good idea?
Rory.
I did. I don't know what
can't believe you've done this.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I know.
I cannot believe you've done this.
I can't believe I've done this.
Also, is the stream up? Yeah, the stream's up. It's just not showing up on my, it's not showing up on my following feed because...
Yeah, if you can't tell if it's up, it's a problem.
Yeah.
A little bit. It's a penis joke.
No, it wasn't, you icky.
Yeah, it was.
Thinking about sex all the time.
Oh, it's crazy, isn't it? They're fucking obsessed. What's
that?
Fucking root rats.
I like your t-shirt, Rory.
Thank you.
It's a black t-shirt.
Oh, yeah, it's
look,
nice.
It's
I like black t-shirts. Okay.
I own a lot of black
I'm wearing a black t-shirt. Isn't that exciting? It's Silver Wastes. That's where Rory is. The fact that I can instantly tell that is mildly upsetting.
I mean, so can I, retard.
Where
it puts you when you...
Wow.
You boost.
Why have you got to be so rude?
Why you got to be so rude?
Don't you know I'm human too?
You're not human, you're Australian.
Oh,
oh nice. I pick option 3. He's not even a person.
Oh, but...
No, you don't get a say in the matter, other than your vote.
Actually, yes, overtook. He's not even a person on that straw poll.
So yeah. That's just rude, isn't it?
Yeah, you're welcome, I voted.
Thank you. Now, how do I get to the top of this vista? That's the real question.
You got up?
Yeah, just go in an upward direction.
It's okay, I did it.
Try not being a massive noob.
Well, that's just really difficult.
Yeah, I know, but, you know, try to restrain your...
My god, so I'm watching the stream, you need to go into the fucking corner. Go into the corner of the platform. For the love
He's
of God, go into the
it.
Corner of the platform.
He's
okay, good.
It.
Sorry, I've got like a minute delay, and I'm just watching it, and it's painful.
You're like a mini person.
He is, he's a little fucking ugly rat boy.
Yeah, rat boy.
Ugly rat boy.
Yeah, he should be the root rat, not me.
Actually, I'm a rat grill, but you know.
You're a rat
fine.
Boy. No, you're a rat boy, okay?
Don't just assume your own gender, Rory.
Yeah, that's fucking rude.
I fucking created the character, of course I can give it a gender.
Unbelievable.
That's sexist.
Unbelievable.
That's basically a hate crime.
I'm so sorry, but I'm also not.
What's my login reward?
So now I'm like, what do I do?
You're supposed to, like, fucking use your spells.
Now you do the story, and then once you've finished the main story, then you go and you do the first mission of the Heart of Thorns story, and then you get the glider and you also unlock the new map, at which point you explore the crap out of the new zones. Or you can get completion. If you get 100% map completion, you can make legendaries, which are the best weapons. I recommend ore. Ore's pretty cool. Go to war. Ore's pretty cool.
You know, I need to do my training first, because I've got fucking... Oh,
You're not even level 8 properly yet.
Wait, who did you just accept a party invite from?
Me.
Oh.
Yeah.
That would make sense.
It would make sense.
It would make sense.
Would make sense. I'm on my mesmer. I've returned to fight at your side. I'm a mesmer.
Copycat.
Really look at once, but like I'm no great Swiss.
Okay. So I meant to be doing my quest, right?
Sure. I'm probably gonna... Actually, I'm gonna switch to my...
You can do my story with me if you want, Tom.
I don't
want
to do your story with you.
Do my story with me, Tom.
I want to do my story.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
I can't believe you've done this.
I can. So, fuck you.
I can't believe you're leaving me with these plebs.
We're not plebs. We're fucking awesome.
We are the best.
We're fucking awesome.
It's character building.
Character building, yeah. Character building exercise. It'll be fun.
It's alright.
It'll be fun.
I've used my... I've committed to my level 80 beast. This is now my level 80 character.
I'm going to send a link to all my friends.
Oh.
Alternatively, you know what you could do? There's a jumping puzzle on the Silver West that's the longest in the game, and it takes like an hour and a half to complete. You could do that.
No.
I think I'd rather like...
I'd rather kill myself.
Also, there are no checkpoints, so if you get lost or if you go the wrong way, that's it, you're fucked. I've never managed to complete it. I've gotten 90% of the way through and then lost it and then rage quit.
Yeah, and that's something that I'm never going to do. Ever.
There's also one of similar length in Lion's Arch. That's also a good kick.
I thought about it for a few seconds and then wanted to die.
Yeah.
So let's safely scratch that one off of the list of things to do.
I'm just gonna go and get this waypoint whilst I'm here.
You know what I'm gonna do?
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna play Town of Salem.
Oh my god.
Game plug.
Everyone, game on stream is Guild Wars. People playing, not necessarily Guild Wars. So, you know, if you came here expecting everyone to play Guild Wars, fuck you! I'm not even playing Guild Wars with Rory, I'm doing my own story quest. This is literally the best.
I'm not even playing a game, I'm just here.
Yeah, Dandai's just fucking here. He's just here for the ride, you know?
Yeah. Somebody's attacking me and I don't know where they are.
Oh, it's... Lightning hammer, frostbow. My equipment is broken and I do not like it. I do not like it at all. Not at all. No, just don't say anything, you know? Fine. I'll just fill the silence.
Yeah.
You know, with me.
No, I was getting attacked by something.
I'm
like,
typing now.
Dude.
I mean, that's just...
You're probably writing some sort of fucking fake will because you're like... GF, right?
I've never been to GF in my life because I'm just a nice
person. I was GF the other day and I was great.
Also, welcome to the stream, Wonderall. Thank you very much for joining us.
Oh, that's that nice person that we played with yesterday. We played League, right?
Yes, maybe.
Yeah. He was the one helping Arix.
Yeah, I think so. Greetings.
The French dude?
Hello. Yeah. You can't just call people a French dude.
I can and will.
I mean, we all turned out the Australian guy.
Yes, because he is.
I mean, we needed a French guy, really, don't I? Mean, we didn't have one before, so.
Yeah, like, we need one from each country.
Yeah,
yeah, we need at least one from every
apart
country.
Apart from
in the
New Zealand and Queensland, because I don't care. Queensland is part of Australia.
Oh my god, even geography?
An abomination.
It's not even part of Australia, it's just an abomination. Kozak will back you up and assist. Nothing redeeming about it. Ow.
Man, I'm so small.
Oh. You have something to discuss. That's funny.
Thank you.
Come on, that was so easy, though.
It was pretty easy.
Make it a bit harder.
Yeah, I'm frozen.
Hello. Help. Again. I was just
admiring your entry. Maybe. Maybe not. Enough for you, eh?
I like an ambitious. Oh no, she'll decide. Thanks. But you haven't seen anything yet.
My crew's demonstration is going to blow you and the other judges fucking away. Fucking story quests. Ambitious and confident. I forgot about this.
Generally, it's great. You know what pisses me off? For my taste. When people skip, like, the other talking bit. We're up, apprentice.
If you can tear yourself away from the founder of this event, the other
judges are waiting. You just
well, yeah. Like,
yeah. At this point, I've done the first half of most stories multiple times.
Your ears are looking fabulous, Rory. We're
standing by to keep blown away.
That point.
My IRL ears or my in-game ears?
Both.
Why not both?
I mean, you can't see my IRL ears because they're underneath a fucking headset.
I can imagine.
They're probably somewhat ear-looking,
I imagine.
Unless you have horribly deformed ears.
Well, what if I do?
They're fucking way too small for my head. I feel like they're out of proportion.
Well, that's better than them being too big. Because if they're too big, then you know, you can't hide them.
I cannot remember which server they are on the roll. I think it's... It begins with the G.
That's what matters.
We're on Gandara.
Gandara.
We're on Gandara.
All that matters is if you're EU or US, and yeah, it's EU makes up. That certainly
sounds impressive. Like, it doesn't matter what server you're on, as long as you're on the EU mega server. You'll need to demonstrate your device for us.
Of course, counselor. I'll pretend I'm a viewer.
Or if you live in China, you can play the Chinese mega server, but only the Chinese get the Chinese mega server.
Mega server 1. This is some fucking judge shit.
You're a
I
shit.
Am the law.
Oh, he's Belgian.
Oh, nice. See, that's better than French.
See, that's why you shouldn't say that.
So you're not French, you're chocolate boy, it's fine.
Ow.
I've been to Belgium.
Not racist.
I've been to Belgium twice, in fact. I mean, the fact that literally, why I've been to Belgium, I mean,
that
I drove
cowboy. Which
I mean, I
prefer?
Drove through it to get to Germany. I mean,
yeah.
But I've still been in it twice. Well, four times, I guess, because you know, I went in one end and came out the other end.
You feel like he's been in you twice.
Yeah. Straight through the middle. It was very nice. It was. There were a lot of fields. And there was a very, very nice service station made out of like glass. It was a good time. Would recommend going to that service station.
It was the best of times.
Yeah.
You need to put like an epilepsy warning on the stream because that fucking skill.
I know. No, it needs to be much quicker to cause photosynthetic. Photo.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you some kind of expert?
I know a little bit. I used to know a guy that had photosensitive epilepsy. He couldn't go in nightclub. He always had to ask the nightclub bouncers whether or not they had fucking strobe lights in.
Wait, Tom. Was it you that didn't realise that Mark had that problem?
No.
Oh, who
was
that?
Someone else. I can't fucking remember. It might have been he who must not be. I cannot remember.
Oh, the fucking retard.
Yeah.
Wow. Rude.
Yeah, We knew a guy called Mark who had, like, I don't know what kind of epilepsy, but he would occasionally just kind of zone out. And then zone back in a minute later. And for him, nothing had happened. But for everyone else, he just kind of sat there staring into space. And I just assumed that it was something he did. And then after like 3 or 4 years, he was like, oh yeah, I went to the doctors and they diagnosed me with like epilepsy or whatever. I was like, holy shit. And then like, he talked about it a fair amount. And then like 4 years after that, someone was like, wait a minute, Mark has epilepsy? We were like, yes! If you could just...
Wow.
It's like a
highly pressurized, ionized
particle. Honestly. A magical
storm. Well, he's decked out in gold bling. Jesus.
I know.
Bling.
I guess Dandar's dad arrived.
Presumably.
Jim or Tim, I can't remember. I think it was Tim.
Jim the Tim. Tim the Jim.
Jiminy.
I actually do like zero damage because I'm using like shit weapons. Nearly got us all
killed. But you're level
80. Being level 80, but I've got shit weapons. But I don't know how I get like good weapons.
But it gives you like the best weapons. Yes. But
it's also it gives really you level 80 weapons. Yeah. Did you actually do the boost, or did you just trial and then travel out?
No, I trialed and then traveled out.
Oh,
yeah,
you
need to actually accept the boost, otherwise you're not actually 80.
Yeah, yeah. It said, do you want to commit? And I said yes.
And it's possible. I mean, it should give you level 80 stuff. You should have a box in your inventory.
I guess I should probably have a box in my inventory.
Full of equipment.
Alright, well, I'll have a look.
Outstanding. What a noob. I'm getting another signal from the Voed. It's similar
to the first and not too far from here. I'd like to check it out. It's almost like I've not done it before. And
I'd like to accompany you. I haven't done it before, but you know. But you know. And in the crew that made it. That didn't stop me. By all means, go. There's nothing. Find else. This new artifact. Render it harmless and bring it before the council. We want to make sure you get the credit you deserve. Many luck. We have to decide who gets to carry the Snaf Savant title. Not it. I hate titles. They always come with expectations and responsibility. Uh-huh. Ah, yes. So if Kazek is accusing himself, that makes the decision an easy one. Congratulations. For your hard work and diligence, you are hereafter the Snaf Prize Savant. Yay. I won the Snaf Prize because I'm fucking the best. Nice.
Not too bothered by chocolate guy. I'm not sure I've been to Belgium. Ever.
I have not.
I have.
No, you haven't been. You haven't experienced Belgium.
I've been in Belgium, okay? That's all I fucking need to say. Okay? It was just a lot of fields and a lot of chocolate. And I ate a lot of chocolate and got so sick of fucking chocolate that I didn't eat chocolate for like a year.
Oh, man.
What a name for Talk Track.
Let's go with that one. Oh my god, there's so many dies.
Yeah. Oh shit, do I have that too? So, can I dye my clothes? Because I'm really not feeling purple and gold.
I was listening to a cutscene.
I don't know.
The other dyes that you get at level 80?
Yeah.
Oh,
I know of a
good use for this. Can I use that?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Oh, I've got my old equipment. Use
wire.
Oh no, do I actually have, like, all this, like, great shit? Where is it? H. Equipment. Yeah, required level 80. Yeah, no, it has given me, like, good shit. It's given me, like, a full set of, like, some of the best shit.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it's not the best shit by any means. It's kind of bad, actually.
Tom's
like,
just jealous.
Well, I got it too.
Yeah.
It gives you, like, standard level 80 stuff. Like, there's a bunch of better stuff. Definitely. Like, I almost immediately replaced it online with cool Berserker gear.
Yeah, well,
for extra deeps.
You know, fucking... I don't have cool Berserker gear, you fuck.
Well, yeah, that's why I fucking bought it, noob.
Well, I'm not...
Goddamn noob lord.
I don't have money for that sort of shit.
Yeah, we'll get some money then.
Oh,
dude, well. Unbelievable.
Somehow. I don't really need to do any crafting if I'm level 80, right?
But you can do. Just to... Well, I mean, eventually you'll need to do crafting together.
I don't need to do it right now, so I'm just gonna... Oh no, I shouldn't. Just get my dowels back at least. Fine, I'll get some more stuff back.
I'm gonna watch Chilled.
Chilled?
Okey-dokey.
What the fuck is Chilled?
Chaos.
Rory.
Huh. You didn't know who he was until I showed you.
Do you have to ruin everything?
I know, well, I mean, I clearly am not ruining it, because, you know, I introduced you. You should be grateful.
I am. He taught me how to play.
Exactly.
And by that I mean God.
You played like twice as much as.
Well.
Yeah, I'm still the master of all information.
No, I need arcane dust for crafting.
Crafting.
Nope. I want that one back.
Goodbye.
Man, I've got so much shit.
Yeah. It's a bit overwhelming.
Goodbye.
But this doesn't even feel like a stream, it just feels like we're in the gym zone, it's great.
Pretty much.
It's a good sort of stream.
That's pretty much what we're doing.
I can't sell some of this shit. Oh well, I'm just gonna get rid of it. It's probably gonna be worth like fucking 5 copper anyway. I'm never gonna use that black iron chest. What the fuck are mango pies? What even are mango? What? Like what? What even is that shit?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
It probably gives you something for a short amount of time.
Probably. Probably. That would make sense. But I don't want to know. Okay, where's the next bit of story quest? Okay, more story quest. There's not only chocolate in Belgium, there are a lot of beers and very good fries too. You missed a lot of those. You should come back to Belgium.
Hmm. That's true. I'd like to go back.
If I went to Belgium, I'd gain like 20 pounds, so... I'm gonna say no.
It's not a country, I don't think I've been to it. I might have passed through when I was like on my way to somewhere else, but... You know, not been deliberately too Belgian. But I've been considering, like, doing some travelling around Europe or something sometime. Getting, like, a Eurostar ticket. You can get, like, a month-long Eurostar ticket so you can go anywhere.
Before you can... before we're not allowed any...
In before dual citizenship, motherfucker.
I mean...
So glad you could join us, Zoe. Yeah, get facts.
I wish. And my entire crew welcome your input.
Crew, the signal points here, but I won't, I've already had an Irish passport, so it's a renewal rather than a new one. We are the standard bearers
for the College of Statics. So right, my plan is to move to Norway anyway. So.
These readings are still in the red. What's with Chase? Has to be
something here. Yeah, my soulmate. Perhaps we're standing right on top of it. My soulmate. We haven't been on the surface
so long we've forgotten how to dig, have we? I bagged it, Tim. Not that we'll actually dig, mind you. There's bound to be a tunnel
or cavern entrance around here somewhere. We just need to find it.
And Savant? Considering the dangerous nature of your last discovery, I recommend we keep our guard up. Shall we proceed?
How far am I through your story?
I'm on the 60s.
I'm on my second quest.
Okay.
Don't actually know where I'm going. Oh, now I found it.
It fell out of your heart.
I followed it. It led me underwater. He was right.
Got an achievement, a large achievement.
I don't know what half these skills do.
Kill him.
I died. Because I don't know what my skills do.
What area are you?
Like, they're like fucking level 10s. And they're fucking wrecking me. I'm level 18.
You're using more than just one skill. Well, you're downscaled, aren't you? You're not level 80, you're level 10.
Oh yeah,
just
that's true.
With some level 80 equipment. Knowing how to play your character, probably.
Yeah, that might help.
Just a little. We just have a little. Item. So Savant,
tell me, what do we? Like, have? I just don't, because I've only just started. Sure. The Voed just tells us where it is and how magical it is. This thing here is packed with arcane energy. A cursory visual examination tells me it's part of something larger, something that was accidentally broken or intentionally modular. Well. We can't learn any more here among these damn foul-tempered beasts. Let's get the relic back to our lab and run some tests. I'll leave it to you. You're not the only ones with big projects that need managing. But if you need more input from me, all you have to do is... Yes,
you do, Jed. Wait, what? Oh, yes. Oh, no. I'll do it.
I believe you can do it. You can make it. You can do it if you really want. And you know, you're getting a fucking, you know, prize and everything. Oh no, I went the wrong way, guys.
Always.
Somebody once told me the world was going to roll me. I am not the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking a tad silly, with her finger and her thumb in the shape of a L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming, something something rules and they hit the ground running. I can't weigh too far with this.
He accidentally shot his Mafia's arm. Oh my god.
What role are you?
No, I'm watching Chills and he was Godfather. And he accidentally shot his Mafia's arm because he wasn't paying attention.
Nice. Wait. You can't shoot the Mafia's arm as a GF.
You can if they're transported or you're controlled by Witch.
Right. Well, Rip and Ripperonis.
Our Lord and Savior.
Danda.
No God.
What?
No God is now watching the stream.
Hello!
Hello, Snow God.
Okay, Alex.
AKA best, oh, best
real name.
Best admin.
Holy shit. careful. Don't want to start a fucking witch hunt against our favourite. That guy's a cool guy.
He's the best though.
There's a Vista on top of here, and I want to know how you get up here. This is fucking... No.
Wait, what the fuck is my Guild Wars name?
Themis?
Oh yeah, okay.
Luna Devereux?
That's League, shh! Themis dot... what was it? Dot...
Knowledge Technician.
This is really fucking difficult. Ooh!
Please remain calm. As
no! Oh my god!
Ugh. What's up, Buttercup?
Oh, I'm trying to do this fucking jumping puzzle and it's like...
Ugh. You need Danda.
Yeah, I do need Danda. Danda, where art thou? Why hast thou forsaken me? Why hast thou forsaken me?
Because the world is a harsh place.
The night is dark and full of terrors.
Can I just Game of Thrones start again?
Summer? Maybe? I did a Vista, guys. Are you proud of me?
Yeah.
Thank you. Ouch. Ouchie. There's like different levels to this place, right?
I have hiccups. Shit.
Have you tried not having hiccups?
Really?
Like, that seems like the most logical thing, really, right?
Yeah, she's such an idiot. Oh my gosh!
Wow.
I'm like just gonna mute myself.
Yeah, that'd be wise. Might be the wise thing to do. See? Hey, you young scallywags, got a phone to pick with me or something. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. Please save me from myself. There's the Vista. There's the fucking Vista. Well, that's just disappointing. I thought it would TP me back to the top if I fell down to the bottom. I was wrong.
I was wrong.
It just killed me.
Nice.
The city. What a place. What a place. So I'm getting XP, right?
Mm-hmm.
What does that XP lead to?
Mastery levels.
Okay. So it's like Diablo where you get to level 70 and then you get Paragon points.
Kinda, yeah.
Man. I remember not last season when I was playing Diablo, the season before. I pretty much haven't played anything in season 8.
I haven't played in a while. I might start playing again because my internet's like probably able to play it now.
Yeah. I was gonna play season 8, but I didn't, because I just I'd played so much in Season 7.
I haven't played in like... I didn't play much in Season 7.
I played fucking ridiculous amount in Season 7. I had I think it was like 570 Paragons. It was fucking ridiculous. And I was... I was pretty good, actually. I was doing, like, tier... 60 something rift, so it's like above Torment 13 and stuff. But and I was having good times doing it with COD, but I haven't played since then, pretty much.
You need to come see the progress we've
Crusader
made.
Was just like it was my jam.
Force is amazing. Also, you were right. It's part of a larger whole or a match set or something. Anyway, there have to be more like this one out there.
We've synchronized a detection wave with our larger global positioning system to achieve long and short range scanning capability.
So the global system gets us in range, then the VOED pinpoints the exact location. Perfect. When can we go after the other pieces?
That right there is why you're my crew, Chief. We're almost done calibrating the global system. Once we have coordinates, we can head out and start picking up the pieces.
Hear that, Shrieksy? We're going on a relic hunt.
This guy's a bit weird.
Alert. Unauthorized intruder detected.
One of the security golems has entered alert mode. Check it out.
I'm checking it out, guys. There's an intruder in the base. I'm gonna have to fuck him up. That was Inquest. Unauthorized intruder has been neutralized.
Idiots. You think you've beaten us? Ha! I was the easy way. Now we'll just have to do things the hard way. Nothing can prepare you for the unfettered fury that is the Inquest attack squad. Go on, beg and plead. Void your bowels in terror. It'll do you no good.
This guy's a few anodizing terminals short of a coding array. I say we feed him to Shrieksy.
The Inquest has never had any interest in our crew's research until now. They must want whatever the VOED is detecting.
Or the VOED itself. I, for one, am not inclined to give them either.
Agreed. Ma'am, if you can gather everyone else at the front entrance, Kazakh and I will handle the rest. And by that, I mean we'll mine the entrance to give the Inquest a nice, warm welcome. We'd better hurry. If this maniac is right, they're already on their way.
Oh, Wondrel, you're here with me. Oh my god.
Yeah, I invited him to the Guild on the Pie.
Nice. He's here doing my story quest with me.
Cool. If you want to join on Discord, Wondrel, I can move you in here. just to say. I'm assuming he's still got the stream open.
I assume so. The turrets are definitely the better ones. And lay like fucking million turrets and make this bit like super easy, it's great. Oh, this fucking game. Pretty much just playing tower defense. It's good. Good shit.
If I know the inquest, they'll send Gollum shock troops in first to soften us up. We'll only see inquest if we manage to survive their Gollum attack.
Alert. Enemy has arrived. Engage it.
Oh my god.
Watch it. They're sending in another team.
Question is, oh, this is a level 80 hammer as well. Nice. Oh my god. The fucking turrets just annihilate. Fucking crazy, man. Like, we don't have to do anything. The turrets just fucking do it for us. We can even place more turrets. Those inquest jackanapes. Oh shit. There's a guy. I need to talk to him.
Well played, Parker. Time for the hardest way. We've planted explosives all along the cliffs overhead. Give me the
what I need.
Or we'll bury this place.
You scrit-shaving devils. You'd threaten this entire community, all these innocent people, just to steal our discovery.
It's all right, Kha'zix. Let them have it. It's not worth the risk. Spoken like a true also-ran. Snaff prize winner.
Why do you think my hiccups have finally gone?
It wasn't so amusing.
Hold your breath.
I forgot that he'd, like, disappeared due to hiccups.
That was very smart, yeah. Savant. Let them have that piece. We know there are more. And we still have the Voen. We can collect them before the inquest does.
And then we force Teo to give us back the first one. Paka, I'd like Zoja to join us. We're going to need all the help we can get.
Capital idea. You and Zoja handle the search. I'll send word to Zoja and have her standing by. Kha'zix and I will start cleaning up here.
Okay. I'm going through and doing my story. Doing well. It's going good so far. Hoodie, return to me.
Return to me. Metal Gear. I never asked for this.
Never played Metal Gear.
Good fun. Would recommend.
I have MGS5, I've just not actually played it.
That's really good. would recommend.
Yeah,
it's the least outlandish of all of them. I mean, it's still pretty fucking outlandish.
Yeah, I hear it's a bit. I hear it's pretty crazy.
Let's talk about good games.
Okay, it's always game,
it
though.
Is a good game.
Yeah, I know. I've played.
Like, it's it's pretty much how that does some of the best games.
Yeah. My next invention. Pretty fucking good shit. Oh, I see. I'm gonna move Wanderer into this interfering. Okay.
All right. Yeah.
I'm gonna abduct him. Boom! Abducted.
Stolen away.
Hello.
Hello. Honeybear said he'll join after Dindins. And I
did. All right. So here
I am. The Honey Master. Lucky for you, I enjoy staying to the
inquest whenever possible. It's
two of us. Master of shit talking. Indicate
the artifact. My Dindins are probably soon, but I'll just fucking eat on the stream.
Well, I'll be like. In a couple of hours, we'll take a break. Take like half an hour break for foods and stuff. Because I need to eat. Get a good look at his stock. Grab what you need, and we'll move on. It's not really stealing. Think of it as Flack's charitable donation to the cause of science in the name of a better understanding of the eternal alchemy. Or just think of it as we need it more and we're smarter than him. Whatever works. Done and done. I'm going to steal you from this guy. You can do that, right? And I'll swipe
whatever's lighting up the Voed display panel. You can't just steal from people.
Yeah, I can.
I'm not safe that, yeah, but as long as you say thank you. For your ears,
Soja, after all these years, it's exquisite to see you again. Go steal for him, from him. I'm gonna run in front of him so he don't see me. So he don't see you.
I thought there was a spot for me in a project.
Hello.
Yours,
I'm there. Hello. I've got a few irons in the fire you might find
intriguing. Let me give you a rough. I can't find what it is that needs that I need to steal.
I don't know, honestly. Gotta run. Did you
know than I expected? Flack was very keen to team up. To a point. But when I mentioned dragons and the inquest, he started looking queasy. I doubt I'll hear from him again. He seemed to have a lot of important things to sell. This is fun. Count me in for the next piece of the puzzle. I don't know. She's like just talking to me. Oh, okay. I think I did it, but I don't. I don't. I don't really remember. Fine. Okay, we're done.
That's it. Okay.
10 out of 10.
You're done.
Best quest. In this game.
Genius.
So genius. Oh shit, I need to get this.
So you're level 80, but you didn't do the story, is that it?
Yeah. Okay. I'm just seeing it now. Oh no, where's my point? Yeah, I just used my my 80 booster for having heart thorns.
Ah, okay.
Because, you know, I couldn't be bothered leveling up. Somebody all the way to 80.
Yeah.
Where's the next? Oh, there it is. It's all the way over here. Well, that's a long way away. It's alright. Waypoints are a thing. Good times. Good times. Yeah, I need to get, like, better gear and I need to, like, get better everything, pretty much.
Money.
Yeah, I know, I need monies. Money. That's must so be funny. In a rich man's world. Bad news.
This place is. Oh, I didn't play this game for too long. I'm so lost. Shit.
Yeah. I've not played very much of this game at all.
Well, I've played a lot, but always alone. So, yeah. For example, I never did dungeons or things like that.
So, yeah, we haven't done many dungeons.
Yeah, yeah, we've done one dungeon that's... and it was...
And it did not go well because Hanbar Knight was like level one. So...
Oh.
Dandar decided that he was going to try to rush through it with some level ones and it did not go well.
Yeah,
yeah, no, I never tried Zen, but things I think they're good, but I'm not sure. Up a pay grade,
fail, and you'll get thrown down a well. It went really well. really well.
That's a lot of Inquest trash polluting the water. I'll be surprised if all the fish don't go belly up. We've definitely got some competition.
Competition? More like distraction. Come on, let's find the artifact. Any Inquest cranial cracking that occurs will be pure bonus.
I quite like the little these little people. They look strange.
Which one?
These guys that we're playing.
Oh yeah.
Little guys. Rats.
Yeah, the little like rat frog things with like sharp as fuck teeth.
Azuras? What's the name in English?
Rat people.
Asuna, I think. Or Ashura.
Asura.
Azura. That's it.
Rat people.
Yeah, that's a
classic. Classic racism by me, the human.
Yeah, fucking.
Ah, yeah, you're the human.
I am.
Humans. Racist. And then racism.
Humans.
Humans are the best race. Everyone knows that.
You just.
Yeah.
Man, you're so racist.
Sure.
Can't help it if we're just better. You know, the Norn are pretty okay too, mostly because they look human.
Yeah.
I mean, the Norn pretty much are just big humans.
Much. Just humans that ate a lot as children. We're all really right. Tall.
That's two pieces of the artifact in our hands. And from the look where of it, there's go? Only
I
one more you. Piece to collect.
I went into the next part of the story.
Yeah, in the console. In the first place.
Yeah.
Then the only question is, how do we retrieve it?
They'll have to dive into a lake and get some stuff.
That gives us two avenues of attack.
Now I've got two one, parts of my artifact. I have a feeling this artifact is going to like be some sort of world-ending shit. It's and then we can have to fight something right at the end. It's like there's some big boss.
What are you trying to find?
I should try to finish my story too, but I'm too lazy.
What bit are you wondering?
I'm level.
I don't know how far through I am.
Like, what are you doing?
My story quest.
Yeah, yeah. What in the story?
Oh, I'm making some sort of artifact.
DVOE.
So, we have to go to the ruin.
I just went into a lake.
Oh yeah, yeah. I think I know that.
And now I have to go. Like, intercept some Inquest guys before they go back to their base.
Yeah. I'm I still... Yeah, I remember... I was trying to find the new place for my story quest, but I didn't find it. It bothered me. So I fucked that up. And I never did it. How am I supposed to go there? Damn. I don't know.
Right.
I honestly don't know. That's so weird. I'm supposed to close
that. Okay, alright. Have they changed how, like, specializations work?
Huh? Which ones? What?
All of them. So I looked online for like a build for a revenant, and it's giving me like I have to pick a like paths on my specialization. So like I don't. It's not how
it
works.
Yeah, that's how it works. That's how the build works. That has worked like forever.
It's not what I'm seeing when I look on my character.
Well, you get like you pick like three trees, then you go like across. You pick from three on each line.
Yeah.
That's how it's always worked.
It's not how I see it on mine.
What? What are you looking at?
It's just like a big circle.
You're looking at training, that's why. You're not looking at build.
That's build. Oh, that's build.
Just above training.
Where's specializations?
These. Oh, there it is. And, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's it.
This makes sense.
Okay. Yeah.
Devastation. Okay.
Whoa.
And then Invocation and Herald. I mean, Herald isn't one. Sounds going well.
Yeah, you won't have Herald yet. That's the super duper one. You need to train that. You need to train them, and then you can add them to your build.
Okay, I understand. Dank. So I guess I'm going to go with this as well, instead. Alright, there we go. I understand, Dank. Thank you very, very much.
I don't even know if my character is any good. I really don't know.
Most things. High level stuff. Like high level raids and stuff. From what I can tell.
Hmm.
I'm actually trying to like speedrun stuff.
Alright, Savant. You've impressed me so far, but it's time to raise the stakes. It's the two of us against a whole Inquest caravan. We need an edge, and I've got one right here. Think you can handle one of my special golem rigs?
Are you kidding?
Oh, this one.
I took my
this
first
is
steps
great.
As a golem pilot the same day I learned to walk with my feet.
Good. Suit
when
up and
you,
get yourself situated.
You become you pilot a golem and you like fuck
I'll
up a golem
ready.
Like an
how do we
caravan.
Keep them contained? If they run,
yeah.
They won't get far. I've had Mr. Sparkles set up a blockade on the bridge.
Mr. Sparkles.
Position, they'll have nowhere to go.
What a guy. I'm looking forward to it. Gatling fists, whirlwind assault. Launch fist, punch, self-repair, good shit. Oh, and they've got a golem.
Yeah, the noise is not fun.
Whee, spin. Deadly dying.
I'm trying to do a jump puzzle. Can't find a way.
Oh man, not fucking jumping puzzles. Oh my god.
Yeah. Sometimes they are very, very easy, but sometimes it's just impossible.
Yeah. We've done some really difficult ones.
Oh, I'm supposed to go there.
Ow!
Fuck shake.
Yeah, a bunch of stitches there. Okay. Oh no. Boss fight. Punch. Spin to win. Heal. Oh no, shit. I need to revive my friend though. I can't believe she just died on me like this. Yeah, now we're gonna fuck him up. Yeah, we fucking beat the boss. Because we're pro. I know. She got out of her mech. And now she's wrecking us. She's got like a shotgun. It's like fucking owning our faces. Oh god. Man, it takes so long. I just wanted to die. It'd probably be quicker if I wasn't in a fucking golem.
I'm falling through the world. I'm dead.
Oh no. Falling through the world is like the opposite of what you want to do.
Exactly what this thing is. Sure about that. But at least now it's complete.
What do you think, Zoja? I think I recognize that symbol and the design aesthetic. Both belong to one of the greatest geniuses who ever lived. Unless I miss my guess, and really, what are the odds of that? This artifact we've been piecing together is the key to Gad's lab.
Gad? He's a legend. At college, we static students spend a whole year studying his work. Nobody's been inside his lab for centuries.
That's about to change. Not a bad day's work, eh? Inquest defeated. Artifact recovered. Access to a historical treasure trove acquired. I need to return the Golem Briggs to my workshop. Meet me at Gad's lab, and we'll be the first to see what he's been hiding for all these years.
Dun dun dun. Alright. Good shit. No, I need to walk all the way back. Why would it do this to me? Oh no, 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 I can just click to leave the instance. It's fine. Yeah. It's fine. It's okay, guys. Now I need to go to this guy's lab. And do the stuff and the things. What are you even up to, Tom? What are you doing?
Doing my story quest.
Oh shit. How's your story quest going?
Pretty okay. I'm at level 61.
Nice. I'm gonna go and do level 10. Fucking, there's loads of it. It's fucking loads of story quests today.
Yeah.
That'd be good. Good to get done though. So Herald is like the super duper epic level 81. So I need to unlock that, I guess. By getting the extra, what's it?
Yeah.
So more farming to do.
This is thrilling. I've been wondering.
Yay.
PvP and buy them. Let's get this over. I like it.
Anyway, now it's our turn. Let's open her up.
Fuck me.
You're hearing this message. I'm either not in.
You're dying at your jumping puzzle.
Yeah.
Get out.
Oh man.
Failure to comply.
I'll try to find my next story quest. Fuck jumping puzzle. Yeah, find it. Jeez.
Your agony may vary. Your death may be monitored for quality assurance. Thank you. Now please run for your life and never come back. Same old Gad, and his creations are still functioning after 2 centuries without maintenance. He was a cranky old cuss, but he built things to last.
Color me impressed. And a tad concerned. If his defenses are as sharp as he was, we'd better watch our step.
Okay.
Get out while you still can.
Breaking into an ancient lab.
Don't look so smug. That trap is merely a warm-up. Maybe you should rethink this little invasion of yours. It's decidedly imprudent.
Oh boy.
I love the fact that I've got this, this tiny hammer that's meant to be a great hammer, but because I'm so small, it's fucking diddy. Don't you?
Getting this far is impressive, I'll give you that. But you're not out of danger yet. In this laboratory, I have harnessed unimaginable forces beyond your comprehension, and I'm about to unleash them on your face. Turn back now, or I'll enjoy desecrating your bones on my return. The pain you are about to experience will outlast your consciousness.
The funny thing is, he's not even exaggerating yet. Still, if he's this determined to stop the intruders, there must be something worth protecting here.
Fucking hell.
My thoughts exactly. I respect Gad and all,
fucking
but we've come too far to give up now. Sorry, old man. Your secrets will be ours.
This guy is fucking crazy.
Don't worry about repercussions. Focus on inflicting concussions.
I'm still in carrots.
There's the power.
Defensive protocols suspended.
Keep attacking.
Fucking wrecking shit. Oh no, okay. It's already dead. It's already dead, guys. I'm so good at this
game.
We
made it. You magnificent malcontent, we've got your number. And we've got this fascinating device Shrieksy found.
Everything in Gad's lab is worth studying. Tuck whatever that is away, and
that's
give it a good
way.
Going over back at your lab.
Fuck.
Done. And am I crazy, or was that containment field holding back destroyers? That alone could revolutionize quasi-physical restraint field theory.
Jeez.
You're not crazy, Savant. If we'd had those fields back when... Well, let's just say more than a few battles might have turned out differently. This was a full-on 100% win. Not everyone can keep up with me, and most don't care to try. Ordinarily, that would suit me just fine. But you're all right. I'll definitely be calling on you again soon. Now let's get that gadget back to your lab and examine the stuffing out of it.
Yeah. Just went into a crazy guy's lab. He's been dead for like 500 years. Found some cool shit.
Oh,
good times. Off back to Rotterdam. Do some trading with some little people. Little froggy rat people.
Rat people.
Fucking worms. Leave me alone.
See, I'm not 100% sure if they're meant to be like... I have this feeling that they're meant to be like a cross between rats and frogs.
Rat people.
I have this vague... Okay. This vague feeling that they're meant to be, like, amphibious.
Hello, Honey Bear.
Hello.
Hello.
Honey Bear.
I'm here to just complain. I'm tired.
Honey Bear, don't give a fuck.
It took me 4.5 hours to do this one job today. And I only had to take 14/1000th of an inch off of it. But the thing is, I put it on the machine, and I was just like, yeah, it was a heat treatment job, so I had to take the outer skin off from it. So I went on, I touched on it, and it made the unmistakable noise of too much pressure being put on the machines. You just heard this noise. So I turned it off in a panic, and when I looked at it, I saw that I had actually put a 6-thou taper on it. You know, which might be good if you're making a table leg, but if it's a bit of hardened steel, then that's virtually unheard of. So I then spent the rest of the afternoon trying to fix the mistake that I made. But that just brings up the question of how did I do that? Because the last job I did on the machine was a similar job. So how did it manage to get 6-thou out of parallel, you know? It's not something, unless somebody threw a hammer at the machine and knocked it completely out of balance, I have no idea how that happened.
Maybe that's it.
Well, maybe. It might be one of the cleaners or something. Just knocked my toolbox out of the way, hit the bed, and it just moves.
Maybe that was it. So, it sounds like you've had a good time.
Yeah. Oh yeah, and that guy, that new guy didn't show up. He was supposed to start.
Oh, nice.
Always a strong start.
Not turning up on the first day.
Well, he didn't turn up last week either. He was supposed to start last week, but basically, he thought that we meant this week. So, you know, that's sort of fair enough. Yeah, whatever. But, you know, if they'd have then phoned up and said, why aren't you here? You were supposed to start today. He said, oh, I thought you meant last week.
I got your message.
Like, you know, you just show up the next day. Side, even for you. What's on your mind? Violence.
But he's never showed up. Yeah, he thought you meant next week. And it's like, oh, well, yeah, we meant now. Like, all right, okay. Well, I guess I can... It'll take me, like, half an hour to get in. I guess I can come now.
Well, yeah, exactly. I mean... Now, out of pure spite, Kudu's invited me to watch him demonstrate... You know, you see on the news all the time, it's like, oh, the job market is really hard to go and move and find another job. Well, you know, maybe there shouldn't be these scrubs... You say they're going to come in and then never turn up, giving everyone else a bad name. I mean, it's not bad for me and the other grinders, because it just means that we're more valuable to the company. Get a copy of your blueprints from the archives. You know, so from my point of view, it's good, but from the company's point of view, it's a nuisance. And honestly, if I was a manager, then I would be quite upset.
Yeah, I'd be pretty livid.
And that's the second time that's happened in 3 months. So you had a guy who was supposed to do assembly work. He was like, yeah, I can do this. Yeah, I'll turn up. It's like, he never turned up. So, yeah.
I guess you don't pay those people either. Like,
well, no, we don't pay them anything because they haven't worked. So.
So I don't see what the point is. Like, through this like interview process and do all the stress of that, and then
to never show up.
Fucking never show up.
Well, the only thing I could think of is he got a job offer from somewhere else that was better, and he just couldn't be bothered to tell us.
But you could at least like say.
You could say, "Oh, sorry, I've got somewhere else to go."
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then that would have wasted. The least you could do.
I know.
2 weeks of our time.
Plain civil, you know.
Yeah.
Civility.
Mm. Just being, well, yeah.
You know, a decent person.
Yeah.
And Steve thinks that. Steve, aka the world's angriest man, thinks that Rich, the workshop manager, just made it up to like make us worry for our job security. And I was like, why would he do that?
Yeah.
He's not a malicious person. And Steve was like, oh, it's all a conspiracy theory. I was like, no, it isn't.
Steve sounds like a right piece of work, to be honest.
I like him. He's a nice guy. He's friendly. But you wouldn't want to come up against him in a dark alleyway.
What a glowing statement about him.
Yeah.
And Steve.
I mean...
He's a nice guy, but I wouldn't want to meet him in a dark alley.
Yeah. If I didn't know him, I would be scared shitless of him. He's a maniac who shouts all the time. And he's gigantic as well. And not fat. He's, like, really...
Just
bulky. Yeah.
Tall.
Built like a outside toilet, that sort of thing.
You mean a brick shit house?
Yeah.
That's something. Being built
yeah.
Is it outside toilet?
Well, being built like a brick shit house is a phrase.
It is certainly a phrase. But yeah, so there was that. No spoke to him for a bit.
About how it was all a conspiracy.
About how it was all a conspiracy theory.
I don't understand this zone!
And then he just started one of his other rants about how the company has mistreated him. And I was like, you've been here for 15 years. If you hate it so much, why don't you leave? Which is what I say to him every time I talk to him. And he said, oh, well, I like the 4 days a week thing. You know, it pays the bills. And I'm like, but it makes you so angry. Why don't you just get a nice chilled out job somewhere, like a part-time job? And it's like, nah. It's like, okay. Okay. Fine.
Yeah. Doesn't really make much sense.
I think he's one of those people who just loves to complain about things.
Yeah. Yeah. I know exactly what you mean. I hate those people.
Yeah.
Oh well.
What else happened?
Fucking Steve, eh?
That was it, sort of. I mean, I did some other work, you know, some of these back caps, which I don't like because most stuff I grind is cylindrical or a circle kind of shape.
Yeah.
But these are sort of a semicircle with this crescent point in the middle and a flat on the other side. So apart from the fact that it's almost impossible to clock it in, which you need to do when you're doing any machining, it also means that it just throws coolant at you because it collects them in nooks and crannies on the piece. When you pour the coolant on when you're grinding, it just flicks it out towards you, which is nice.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
So, I guess you're not a big fan of grinding that shit.
I like grinding, I just don't like grinding those.
Yeah, that's not right. Grinding that stuff.
I don't like grinding the copper steel shafts either, because grinding copper really stinks. I can't really... It sort of smells like a burnt plastic.
Well, lovely.
Sort of glue, sort of combination. You have a look at it and you think, oh, is this? You take it up to your face to give it a good inspection. You just knock yourself out with the smell and you're like, oh, God, that's awful.
Yeah. What? How I feel every time I see you anywhere.
What, when you pull me up to your face to inspect me closer? You just think, oh, what's that smell?
Yeah. I'm like, oh god. What is this?
I'm glad you're here. I heard Kudu's lackeys were going to attack the archive.
As the most exciting thing that happened to me today was I had a haircut.
Oh, nice. What did you go for? Hashtag fresh trim.
He's one pretty step much ahead just, of us, then. Like, I didn't get any light stuff. I just, well, I had it layered and thinned a bit. And that was it.
Yes.
Which is I had my a bit more shaved off the side and it, like, some trimming around the bit where it goes from the long hair to the short hair. So it's a bit more blended. And the side reshaped. That was it.
I haven't had a haircut in over a year. Which is alright. I mean, soon, you know. Well, I keep it clean, so it's not really a problem. But...
found it, finally. I found my story quest.
Ah, nice.
Jeez. 3 hours later.
3 hours later.
3 hours later.
No, I'm... Yep. Oh, I need to succeed in it. Which won't be easy.
So, it did go fairly quickly. I mean, on the whole. Because I was concentrating all day, which means the day fucking faster.
Yeah, that's true.
It does mean I've gone slightly cross-eyed, though. Because my glasses haven't come yet. That I need for work, and he said it would be a few working days. And I did it on Friday, so that's like Wednesday probably.
Mm.
I'll pick it up on my lunch break. Still, can't complain. It's free.
Yeah, you can. Of course you can complain.
Well, you know.
Try asking Steve about complaining.
Yeah. Just like, I say, oh, Steve, what do you think of this? And he's like, oh, it's fucking shit.
Classic Steve.
Oh, classic Steve.
Steve, the world's angriest man.
Mm.
I love Steve.
Oh, we all love Steve. But yeah, at heart, he's a big softie. He gave me his apprentice book, like the one that he had when he was a youth, which I thought was nice of him.
That is nice of him. Well, okay.
Well, you know, he's passed down this heirloom. And yet, you know,
too late. The evidence we needed to prove he stole my idea is now a pile of ashes, soot, and failure. Not a failure, a setback. Now that we know who's up to something,
still, it could be worse.
We just need to figure out what it is and how to stop it.
Yeah, it could be worse.
I'm ready.
Could be French.
Plagiarism and arson are
one.
But wiping out
did you just say you could be French?
First invention,
no, I didn't.
I'm going to text you could be French. Butt with
bootprints.
Yeah. That's what I like to hear.
Goddamn, one of goddamn Frenchies.
Has a lab nearby.
They've got nothing on Belgium.
Still smells like smoke. No, don't get me started.
Meet me at Plunka's lab. I predict
she's having, you know, having driven through both, I can safely say that I prefer driving through Belgium.
Having been to France and not to Belgium, I can safely say I prefer Belgium.
Nice, that's a glowing review. That's basically saying, I wish I'd never gone to France.
I used to go to France every year as a kid. I quite enjoyed it, but, you know. Fucking
what's
Belgium,
the problem?
Man. Yeah, it was like literally every year for like 7 years.
I feel so sorry for you.
Come on.
I feel sorry for the French.
France is not that awful, is it?
Well, you know, it's not Germany, so you've got that going for you.
What's wrong with Germany?
I quite enjoy Germany.
Just everyone, wow.
I like Germany.
You know what my favourite country that I visited is? Portugal.
What?
Never been. Portugal is nice.
Very, very, very nice. Very nice country.
I've been to Spain, but not Portugal.
I'd say it's just like a better version of Spain, to be honest.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, Portugal is very, very nice place to be.
Yeah.
on vacation, at least.
I've been to Switzerland, which is very nice. Switzerland is how a country should be run, I think. I've been to Spain, that was pretty good. The cathedral in Barcelona is lush.
It is pretty lush. It's not finished, but it's pretty fucking good.
Yeah, they reckon they'll have it finished soon, but I sort of don't believe them.
They've been saying they'll be having it finished
soon.
Yeah,
they've been saying that for 30 years.
Fucking 20 years.
Yeah, exactly.
I tell you what, though. Because basically, Gaudi, all of his drawings got burnt down in a fire or something. All of his design work. So they've had to get in other artists and sculptures to, you know, fill in the blanks, basically. And the one that they've got on the west side? I can't remember. It's the entrance, the side you go in. You know, whoever did that is clearly an idiot. You know, you could go to the local Barcelonian preschool and, you know, they could have designed a better wall. I could have designed a better wall.
Wow.
Tasmus asks if you would mind if he joins the voice channel.
He's free to join the voice channel. I'm sure he'll provide greatly to the ambiance of the voice chat.
Yeah.
With his dulcet tones.
How do you... Wouldn't it be amazing if and when Tasmus starts to use a microphone, he has an accent almost identical to me, or speaks in a proper thick West Country accent? That would be beautiful.
But he's finished.
I know he's finished, but you know.
So what's the likelihood of him fucking speaking in a West Country accent?
We've got a Lithuanian guy at work, and he sounds like he's from Australia. So you never know.
Did he grow up in Australia? Is he like Danda?
No, he's born in Lithuania, and then he came to this country 10 or 12 years ago, I think he said.
Yeah.
So, and he's like, 30 maybe. Yeah. So, he's got his accent, you know.
Yeah.
But it's not to the point you can't understand him. You know, I can understand him easily, but you hear his accent, but he doesn't sound well. He doesn't sound Lithuanian. He sounds Australian. Which is a bit peculiar.
Did he learn English in Australia?
No, he learned it here.
Yeah, that's weird.
Did he watch a lot of Neighbours?
For example, my English teacher has a very Scottish accent, while she is 100% Belgian, so it's a bit weird. But I think it's because she learned English in Scotland.
I had my GCSE Spanish teacher. She learned a bit of English, you know, when she was in Spain, because they do. But when she moved over to this country, just for like a gap year to improve her English, she moved to East London. So the standard English that she had been learning in Spain, she had no idea what they were saying in East London.
Yeah.
Because they were all speaking in Cockney accents.
I mean, I have no fucking idea what people from East London are talking.
Have you ever seen the film Attack the Block?
I've not.
No, but I've seen adverts.
I couldn't watch that because I couldn't understand what they were saying. And that is set in London.
That's fucking crazy.
The other film I had to stop because I couldn't understand was District 9? The alien one?
Fucking prawns, mate.
Yeah, the South African one. I couldn't understand them earlier. But that's okay, because, you know, I feel slightly bad that I couldn't understand people from the same country as me.
Yeah.
It's not some thick Glaswegian accent either. Little more than kindling. But no, I couldn't understand the South African one. His service, and now I can't get away. I've seen what he did to the ones who tried to run. We can help. I know how to deal with Kudu. Get us out of the cell, and we'll get you out of his clutches.
That's pretty crazy. I remember there was a film that was set in Glasgow. This may be my only chance. Put on at the Cannes Film Festival. I'll release you. Any enemy in is a friend of ours, Peridier. And they had to put subtitles in because even the English speakers couldn't understand it.
Yeah.
Because they were speaking with incredibly thick Glaswegian accents.
Yeah, I can see that. Oh dear. I think that's it. Other than that, I can understand people pretty well. You know?
Hey, BB.
Hey, baby. You want a picnic basket, poo-poo?
Hey, BB, you want some duck?
Kudu wanted you alive and suffering, but I have different priorities.
Oh, dear.
Do you want some picnic basket?
I've been on a picnic in ages. But then again, it's not pick weather, is it? I mean, I can't really think of. Yeah, that's it. That's my whole conversation. I've ranted about work. That's it.
Yeah, I'm that's done. Pretty much it.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, I'm like, you know. I feel that with, like, you, because you've gone to university and everything, and you have a range of social aspects as such that you could do, because there are all those clubs and everything. Here, I just, like, you know, I go to work, and I go to college for lectures, but everyone I interact with is quite similar to me, in a sort of a engineering sort of way.
Yeah. Finally.
I think it's interesting because I think it attracts a certain type of person. For once, he won't
see coming. Which sort of makes everybody an extreme memer.
I would qualify Steve as a huge meme lord.
Yeah, I mean,
really?
I mean, pretty much every like engineering person I've ever talked to is like the same person.
Yeah. Also, extreme arrogance. There's that. And the phrase gets uttered around a lot, sort of like, oh, well, you know, computers may be cool and all, but you need to have people who can actually make things, which is said all the time. You know, my dad says it, Steve says it, Rich says it, I say it. It's like...
weird because my dad's an engineer.
Mm.
He's an electrical engineer. Does more teaching and stuff.
Yeah.
And, but his opinion on like 90% of things is, why not have a computer do it? I mean, my dad gets fucking annoyed when he has to get a replacement car from his company car for a little bit because it's being MOT'd or something, and his car keys, he has to press a button to open the door.
Yeah, you see, like,
it's ceaselessly complaining for like weeks. Like, oh my god, I can't believe I have to press a fucking button to open my car.
Hmm. Like, wow. That's pretty crazy. He's just used to having it like automatically sense his car, his keys, and his the car.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've never even known that technology existed. I've never seen a car.
Oh yeah. Like
that.
It's like super common now.
Yeah, I mean, my mum's company car does that.
Yeah, most new cars do. Right. My dad's car key isn't a key. It's like a thin bit of plastic, and then you just, like, as you walk near the car, it unlocks the car, and then you just press the start button. Like, there's no car key or anything, just a button that says start.
That's fucking crazy, man.
That's how most new cars work.
Yeah. Wow. If you've got a really good car, like my Fiat Panda, then you need to press a button. In fact, I've been using the spare keys on the car for, like, a few months now. I'm convinced that the main set of keys are cursed. Basically, I have had no problems with my car in the 1.5 years I've had it. You know, you don't often say, God, Italy, they're great engineers. But honestly, Fiat know how to whack a car together. But anyway, a while ago, I was just, you know, going to go out with my friends. And suddenly the keys wouldn't work. Hmm. In that I'd unlock the car, I'd get in, I'd turn it on, and then suddenly...
It's been wild, then.
It wouldn't run.
Hmm.
You know, the starter motor wouldn't work, and we thought, oh, well, it's a problem with the battery, or it's a problem with the starter motor. Looked at the starter motor, nothing wrong with it, got the battery changed. What happened? Exactly the same thing. So, you know, I was like, what could this be? And in the end, I thought, you know, actually, maybe it's the immobiliser I've got in the car, because it's an external thing. So I got the key in the immobiliser, no, the battery in the immobiliser key changed. So I thought, well, maybe there's a sequence that it's running that it can't finish because the battery's going flat in it or something, you know, before it can do its thing, you know. So I changed the battery in it. It does exactly the same thing.
Okay.
So basically, I have no idea what's happening. I was just like, oh. And through some... Kudu's lab is just ahead. I spoke to my dad's friend who works for an oil rig or something. He was saying, here's something you could try. Try using the spare set of keys for the car. And I was like, what? And he said, honestly, try. And I was like, okay. And it worked. And the car started up first time. So this isn't the immobilizer, it's the car keys. Why it does this?
How weird.
Yeah, it makes literally no sense. So yeah.
My car caught fire the other day.
Did it?
Yeah, I wasn't here, but my dad was fixing my car because well, the car hadn't been it hasn't been driven in a fairly long while. So my dad decided to fix it, and he said that I can't remember what it was that exploded, but something didn't like something that had happened, and it just spontaneously combusted. He said I should be very disappointed that I missed it. I am. I wish I had. It would have been cool. I like watching things catch fire and explode.
Yeah, it does sound pretty cool.
Look who finally caught up with the rest of the class. I heard you needed help to escape from my
trap. Yeah, I don't remember the car, though.
Big surprise there, right?
So yeah, basically well, apparently the main set now. Of keys for my car recursed. My Rhythmatic
5000 is fully functional and ready to make
Yeah, apparently my car works now, so I just need it MOT'd and then,
That's my invention, Kudu.
Drive it again. You're a derivative thief, I can go to all those places that I don't go to. Tell your tailor that other
colors exist. You can get it sawned if you're not using Snap's it.
Sidekick brought a sidekick of her own. Sidekick. Yes, I stole
it. For some reason, we haven't.
And improved it 1,000-fold.
I mean, I'm fucking home every few weeks.
Your device could make it snow for winter's day, or turn gray skies blue for a child's picnic. I turned that toy into a weapon of unmatched potential. Dark clouds are gathering over Ratasum as we speak, Savant. I hope the Council can swim, but you're sunk. Inquest, attack.
Okay, alright. These guys are fucking crazy. He wants to make it rain all the time.
Tell us about the Guild Wars stream.
It's some. You call this resistance? Getting it right. Doing my story quest.
Mm-hmm. Have you got any epic loot? This
keeps up. Not really. I may have to, this has been fun, but I think no, he's just like fucked up. I beat him in a fight and he's like, lol, nope.
Where's Kudu? I'm going to wrap his ears around his own neck
right
and pull until his head pops
you
off.
You motherfuck.
Good plan, but Kudu's long gone.
I burned down a monumentally large forest. It's still burning now.
How did you do this?
Well, there's a massive forest outside my base, and there's an oil field that I need to, you know, get some oil from. And the trees were getting in the way. I thought, what's the quickest way to get rid of a bunch of wood? I know, I'll burn it down. Yeah. So, you know, I made an oil refinery. Refined my oil into petroleum, light oil and heavy oil. Made the light oil and heavy oil into flamethrower fuel, made a flamethrower, and then set off to work. And I started a fire, and the entire fucking universe is burnt down. It's nice. Like a massive wave of fire. Like, Jesus Christ, it's all the way down here. It's gone miles. There's just a forest of just blackened trees, charcoal. I've just got to... I'm burning down the rest of it. And now the bugs are attacking me again. Maybe they don't like it, the fact that I burned down half the world.
Yeah, I wouldn't be impressed.
Yeah, they're actually sending some guys down. Oh, the fire actually reached them. Oh, the fire reached them and they're dying. That's hilarious.
I wonder why they're mad at you then.
Well, they're mad at me because I'm polluting their world, but, you know. Fuck them. It's my world too now. Yeah, it actually killed a whole alien base.
Holy shit. What a nice guy. You're so nice.
Yeah, huge hive full of aliens. Dead. Nice. Didn't even have to do anything. Just continuing to burn down these forests. Don't want any dirty wildlife going on. You know how it is.
Oh, okay. I understand. Can't believe you've done this.
It's quite an impressive fire, honestly. I'm quite proud. The monumentally huge amount of damage I've done.
Oh, yes. It's massive fire. My crowning achievement.
Oh, it is. I mean, I have yet to top this.
Nice. Sounds good, man.
Feels good, man.
Like Rattison. Good old Rattison. Fucking, how many fucking waypoints are there in Rattison? There's like fucking 9 of them.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, I've imparted my rage and wisdom to you, but me and Tasmus are going to emigrate now.
We're
gonna go play some Ubermensch, and also we've got Ducky in tow, so.
Ducky in tow.
So see you later, Scrubs. Have fun with the stream.
Oh yeah, bye.
What a rude dude.
The rudest of dudes. Maybe next year. That's what you said last year. The rudest of dudes. Okay, I think I've got all the waypoints in Rattison now. Now I just need to get all the, like, things where it's like, this is like a place. Go here. Alright.
This is a place. Go here. Go here right now.
Get some free XP for going here. Congratulations. You're so good at the game. I'm just like MLG Pro, obviously.
MLG.
MLG Pro Gameplay.
Here, folks. So pro, you won't believe how pro it is.
I can't believe how pro it is, and I've been thinking about how pro it is for the past 3 minutes.
I can't believe it's not pro.
Why the hell doesn't a team pick this guy up? He's literally the best player I've seen in years. Interesting. Yeah, that's exactly how it goes, right? Target reassignment.
Hostile. God, he's. Ooh. You're sending me.
He's literally the greatest player ever made. Why am I so speedy? Explain it to me.
Supposed to be what now?
Why am I so speedy?
Accelerating. I don't know. Why are you so speedy?
I do not know.
Well, fucking find out then.
I do not know. Well, no, I don't know. I went through this room, and this guy was doing, like, this weird sound happened. And then I was all quick.
Sounds like a hack to me. Hashtag banned forever.
Oh no. I'm already banned as a heretic.
You are a heretic. Careful.
I can't be banned as well.
Careful.
No, oh, I'm gonna die. Rip me! There we go. I took 856,000 points of damage.
Bad. Not bad.
Not bad. Not good. Not bad. All prices are non-negotiable. Probably shouldn't have taken that much damage, but you know. Oh well.
Probably shouldn't have taken all that medicine. I'm dead now.
This may or may not be my downfall. I'm trying to find this point. I just can't find it. It doesn't seem to exist.
Of course it does. Probably underground or something.
No. I'm on the lowest level.
You sure your doctor's a massive noob?
Yeah.
How sure?
Pretty sure. Yeah, where's the final? Where's the other vista? There's one vista I've not done. I don't know where it is. I don't understand, Tom.
What don't you understand?
I'm gonna blame you.
And why do I care?
Because you're being blamed.
Yeah, but that doesn't affect me. Try again!
Let's enter this instance.
What?
I'm talking to the council. It's level 20. I found the place. It was in the Arcane Council. I had to go to like a special place.
I hereby convene this special session of the Arcane Council. The floor is yours, Kudu.
Wait, or
make
should
it good. We're busy people.
I guarantee you'll be impressed, counselors. My Weathermatic 5000 will change the world, starting with yours.
Stop! Kudu is setting you up. He's going to use that machine to flood Ratasum permanently.
Ah, Zoja. I trust the council is familiar with Snaf's former menial, and the Snaf's servant, a menial's menial. So glad you got my invitation, dear.
When?
I was afraid something
so
terrible
rude.
Had happened.
This guy's
to you.
Rude. The no rudest
matter.
Of dudes.
Plenty of time for that later. I have to run now, counselors. It's a wee bit failure heavy in here for my taste. Enjoy the show.
So fast, Zoja. The council can take care of itself.
Yeah, I've made the magnificent discovery on Factorio. I have invented batteries.
I'm Snaf, just like Kudu, so shut up and let me save us all. Trust me, this thing's booby-trapped to seven elements. utensils. Keep them off me while I work.
Okay.
Environment. Completely fucked. I have polluted everything.
Nice.
Just as it
should.
Defensive protocols suspended.
So much. So much pollution. So little time.
Fuck the environment.
Yeah, fuck the environment.
Landmines.
Landmines?
Big fun.
Ooh. Landmines. Hello.
Oh, I could... I can't remember this.
Robotics. There we go. Okay. It's going good. Doing fucking story quests.
Deluge in your chambers and a bevy of hostile elementals. Is the council ready to declare Kudu a threat, or do you need more proof?
The council is well aware of the animosity between you and Kudu. For all we know, you can.
At which quest are you now?
I, for one,
I am. I was on level 20. Kudu like threatened the council with some weather investigation.
Yeah. Okay.
Which will take months to reach a conclusion, if it ever does. With respect, counselor, you're a buffoon. If Zoja and I hadn't...
Let it go, savant. It's Ratasum. The council's main duty is to preserve itself. These days, that means knuckling under to the inquest. We stopped Kudu and destroyed the machine he stole from you. I'm gonna count that as a win. But I'm getting increasingly tired of council politics. Keep yourself available. I've got a few irons in the fire, and I'll want you with me when they're ready to come out. I'll be in touch.
Okay. Do a quest, get some free stuff. Mastery point earned. Good shit. I got some mail.
I need more solar panels, even if they are good for the environment. Don't want to be half environmentally friendly, but... My mattress.
Are you just like deliberately doing things that aren't good for the environment?
Solar panels are very good for the environment, thanks. You know, all the mining and power that goes into making them isn't, but... No?
Yeah.
Installing some yummy solar panels, like, everywhere. Solar good panels are now responsible for approximately 25% of my energy creation.
Nice.
Have you know.
Good, you got my letter.
I'm going to make a factory that just automatically makes it soon. Need more power than what I have. Just about meeting. But
seventh
like
law
some
of dynamics posits that magical emulators. Energy cannot be destroyed. Today
he
I
took
will prove that magic
what?
Is a limited resource, like water,
40 solar panels
or timber. Using my advanced equipment,
okay.
I have detected significant drops in the world's ambient magic. This drop, I believe, is directly attributed to the return of the Elder Dragons. They consume magic.
What are solar panels made of?
If the dragons are not stopped soon, they will leech all of the magic from the world.
Ah, bosh!
Magic doesn't get consumed. It changes form and concentration, and it always returns. It's part of a closed system.
I have proof.
The data is gone.
Get off the
stage.
Where
did I leave those notes? I must have left them in my lab. Please, excuse me while I fetch my records. I can prove the problem exists, then we can focus on its solution.
Okay. So this guy is like, Professor, oh hey, Bo, magic is actually like a limited resource, and everyone's like, you're fucking crazy.
Fuck him. Fuck him.
How know what he's on about. Helped?
Thank you for coming. I see a lot of overlap in Gore's theory and our shared goals.
As do I. If Gore's research aligns with the Priory's, we may be looking at a cultural revolution.
Revolutions are won militarily, not academically. Still, Gore's theory could prove useful.
I agree, but nothing can happen until Gore makes his case. Why don't we all settle in and listen?
Okay. Alright.
Greetings.
Come on. Zoya.
Savant, allow me to present three of Ratasum's finest minds. Slep of the Vigil, Batanga of the Order of Whispers, and Crosso of the Durman Priory. I asked them here to listen to Professor
Where
Gore's
do
speech
people
because
get
they all
their
have an
wings?
Interest in fighting the Elder Dragon.
I don't know.
Pleased to meet you, Savant.
I was wondering.
The Durman Priory is dedicated
it's new to me.
An exploration that will help us combat the
wings?
Elder Dragons.
As you can Danda. Imagine, Possibly
we've
Danda's
been watching
here.
Professor Gore's progress with key.
Is he the expert for Guild Wars 2?
Yeah, he's a resident Guild Wars 2 expert.
Okay, I see.
Something to know, Danda probably
we
knows.
Specialize in covert activity, information,
was it this week he was going away?
I understand you're more of a doer than a researcher.
Going away
so
at some point.
You'll appreciate this.
Oh, February, I think. Sometime in February. We intend to use which is this month, but I don't know when.
How
about.
Clear does a target have to be for you sneaks?
Yeah, sometime in February, I was like confused. I was trying to work out like what you meant by that. Like next February? Last February?
I have a feeling he thought it was.
I'm here to see if Gore's work.
At a time, he thought it was. Oh no. I don't know.
Gore's theory is groundbreaking.
Oh, do I?
It might be February. It might also be April.
I'm interested to hear him finish his presentation.
I don't know. I have a feeling it might
be.
Let's see if any of during Insomnia.
Yeah, but he's going away like sometime like now, isn't he? Like as well. I don't know. I don't fucking know.
I mean, his dad's here. That doesn't mean that he's away.
I know his dad's here fucking today. I swear he was going somewhere at some point. This is like soon. I don't know. Maybe I'm thinking of something. Probably thinking of something.
I don't know. I don't know. I don't care.
Whoa, how do you not care about Danda?
No, I did care about Danda.
I have just been informed that our colleague Gore will not be returning.
Here we go. Solar panels being automatically created. This is one. This is true efficiency. Now I need to make plastic. Another thing that's just marvelous for the environment.
No! Fucking cliff. Fuck.
Okay, all my light and heavy oil is being made into flamethrower ammo.
This guy died in a tragic lab accident.
I jumped into the void. Like, right away. Goodbye!
It does. I'd like to
no, don't res me, you
so if the arcane eyes involved, you may not get that chance.
I'm too far.
The Order of Whispers
can't res me.
The arcane eye serves the arcane council, right? They have to do what the council says. It's in their charter. We simply pay a visit to High Counselor Flax's lab, find the materials to make a convincing forgery, and walk right past the arcane eye.
I have many calls.
Oh, unnecessarily complicated. Simply to just outwit the sentries outside Gore's lab.
Literally
the arcane
thousands.
I can't match the Priory's brain power.
I'll leave fact-finding to the Priory and Whispers. When you lot establish a clear objective, the Vigil will be ready.
Listen, Savant. I'm pursuing a long-term, big-picture strategy here. So I want you to take charge. Choose the most viable plan and see it through. We need to know what Gore was going to show us. And if he was silenced, we need to know who did it and why. Good luck.
Okay, level 30.
You've chosen
Let's get started.
I'll meet you outside Gore's lab.
Let's get started.
We make the same
prediction. Woo, yeah. Where's my bag of loot? There it is.
Where's the loot?
Show me the loot.
Show me the money.
Show me the monies.
Show me the money.
Money.
That's what's funny.
In a rich man's world. Who are?
Here we go. Making some posts.
All the things I could do. If I had a little
right.
Money.
My administrative discussions exhaust me.
Actually, they're quite entertaining and enlightening.
Wish I had more money. Participating. Doesn't everybody?
No, the wrong guild was. Just win the lottery and then sue the lottery people because you were felt you were too young to enter the lottery. You know, instead of doing anything useful, just complain. About
I
having
thought
money.
That's like fucking amazing.
Fucking worst.
Oh man.
What a massive fucker.
It's so stupid.
Suing for mental anguish because you won the lottery. So silly.
Well, so. It works, I guess.
Well, she hasn't successfully sued
her. I think I have a pretty shitty armor because I'm dying. No.
What class are you?
Engineer. Yeah.
Engineer. Apparently, engineer is pretty difficult.
Yeah, I didn't choose the easiest for my first character.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I love so much engineers, so
yeah.
Find it so funny to play. But fuck, I'm dying all the time. Ah.
Dandel may or may not have issue with the fact that you're playing an engineer.
Yeah, he fucking
why is though?
Because they're not like meta. They're like kind of meh. They don't really do anything in particular really, really well.
Yeah, that's the big problem I found with them. It's,
yeah, which is
you're good,
which
but
is why, like,
you're not really good.
Yeah, but, and like to actually get like top tier DPS or tanking or like whatever out of them, you need to be like, you need to know what you're doing.
Yeah, I kinda see that. I kinda see that.
Yeah.
I have a mage, but She's not level 80. Maybe I should put it.
Yeah, I recently got my elementalist to it. Good fun.
Yeah, elementalist. It's good.
I'm currently playing a revenant.
Oh god, I've reached the point on Factorio where I keep forgetting what I'm supposed to be doing. Oh yeah, Red's advanced circuits. I remember.
Yeah, I'm not doing any damage. I'm dying over. I'm dying non-stop and I'm doing no damage. That's a problem. I thought I...
What's going on here? We have an appointment with... There's nothing going on and nothing
plus,
to see
I can
here,
play
Susan.
Properly this game,
inside.
So...
We're expected.
It should be it too.
My orders come from Agent Racked himself, and he says no one gets in without clearance from the Arcane Council. Move along.
Okay, they won't let us in.
Empirically speaking, we're not getting in through the front door. The guards won't risk getting on Rakt's bad side. He's a particularly nasty character. We need a better plan and fast. The Priory's reliquaries are full of magical items. If the dragons feed on magic, those reliquaries become prime targets.
We could overpower the guards, grab what we need, and fight our way out.
Too public. We don't want to alert the entire Arcane Eye and everyone else in the vicinity. We need to think.
We're starting to talk
in.
About Elder Dragons. Rakt, I have a feeling the Elder Dragons are like
cautious.
A big deal.
He would have sent hazmat suits to analyze dangerous areas in the lab. Follow my lead. I've got an idea.
They may or may not be like the main antagonists and like the final bosses of the game.
Maybe.
Maybe. Just maybe.
I don't know.
You study astronomy?
because you're about to see stars.
Quit! Help!
Zero time.
They won't look twice.
I'm in a golem now, guys.
Nice.
We've got hazmat golems coming in. Open the doors.
Yeah, open the doors, guys. We're totally not here to tell you secrets.
Look there. I believe the common parlance is a body bag.
There's a body bag, guys.
Look at this, Crasso. I don't know this poor devil, but it's definitely not Gore.
I concur. The Arcane Eye must have him socked away somewhere. And if Gore's not here, there's no need for us to linger.
Okay. Agreed. So they've abducted this guy. He was saying magic is like or that could a finite resource, not infinite.
We
one.
Have entire libraries full of information on the Arcane Eye, on Rapt, and on Gore's research. But this doesn't make any sense to me.
And he was like, yo, we need to fucking deal with the Elder Dragons because they're eating up all the fucking magic, you pricks.
With that in mind, let's make a graceful exit before Rapt gets wise.
There is some magic solar panels.
Nobody's supposed to be on shift right now. Identify yourself.
You know, a renewable source. Our orders are to that way they can just feed the dragons. No one has to give a shit. Makes perfect sense.
What are you doing here?
We're just, never mind. Time to fight.
Intruders! Shut down all hazmat suits! This area is compromised.
Assemble the crew!
I love how fucking ridiculously convoluted my Factorio Factory's getting. It just doesn't make any sense. It's just a winding mess of conveyor belts and arms, throwing things everywhere. Solar panels. Oh, 34 solar panels
sounds
down.
Sounds about right, to be honest.
Oh, I'm making the big ones now. Batteries. 64. Mmm.
Oh no. We've been arrested.
What's going on here? Who are you?
We're admirers of Gore's work. We came to pay our respects to his body. But as you can see, it's not here.
I have no idea what you're talking about. There's nothing even remotely out of the ordinary here. Except you. Since this is a secure area, and since you're not authorized to be here, run. Or I will exercise my right to use lethal force.
Let's go, Crasso. I want to regroup with the others and find out what they and Zoja make of this.
Carry on, Savant. I'll meet up with you and the others.
Like a dedicated solar panel.
Now I need to.
First, I need to burn down this.
Now I need to run away. Fucking. There's so much shit. Fucking story quests. Fucking story quests.
Burn, baby, burn. Burn, 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 burn. Okay, forest is burning down. May have accidentally set fire to some of my own stuff. Who gives a shit?
Okay. That's it.
Too long.
I'm gonna arrest this guy.
I put in a request for a transfer to Ebonheim.
The bugs are attacking me from the west now, too. Oh, they're starting to group together. Extracting gold from humans is child's.
Satchel without
complaint. Is that
forest? Extracting gold from humans is child's play, apparently, according to this guy.
Nice. I know what it's like. Sounds like a pleasant guy.
Yeah. He's essentially saying, yo, humans are stupid.
He's not wrong.
So, you know, whilst you're being racist. Saying, you know, humans are literally the best.
Yeah, they are the best, but they're still stupid. You know, it's just that all the other races are just more stupid.
There's the power. Doesn't make sense.
Of course it does.
But, like, I don't think you're right. I don't think you're right. What humans don't make, like, place? Fucking magical golems and contraptions and shit.
And how often are those fucking magical golems useful?
Quite often.
Really? Because they always just try to kill me. Seems like they're
well, that's
really
kind of the point.
Yeah, what's
this
the point?
This is how you kill people.
Just kill things yourself. You know, good exercise.
It's just, you know.
Now, you shouldn't be a lazy man.
No.
Robots
but
are,
bolsters
robots
the army,
are
right?
People too. Robots are people too.
Robots are people
force
too.
Them to, can't just force them to do your dirty work. That's just rude.
Is it?
I mean, yeah. Robots are people.
Robots are people too. What you
know? I'm fully with you on robot rights, but you know.
Why are you forcing them to kill people?
So then? Gore's death
I'm not. That's right. You're such a fucking. Well, I mean, then when are your robots helpful? You know. While
you poke around in back alleys, they also like, you know, do stuff for you.
Like
moving stuff.
That sounds a lot like slavery.
But they're not sentient.
But you said robots are people too.
Sentient
I think we've got
robots.
A racist on our hands.
Sentient robots, people.
Yeah, but, you know, why are you denying them sentience?
We're just not giving them sentience.
Yeah, but you're denying them sentience. How rude is that? Unbelievable. Got a bad racist on our hands, everyone.
Yeah, I'm a robophobe.
If he is, the Arcane Eye has him. They run a remote facility in a human village called Garenhof.
Probots and robophobes.
Remote, a perfect place
nice.
To stash gold.
It's a song.
Finally, a concrete objective. Just good say
song.
The word,
yeah,
and I'll have vigil soldiers standing by to storm Garenhof.
That's
pretty much.
No,
it's pretty much the theme tune to fucking Fallout 4.
But I'm better. We can use Garenhof's low profile against him. I say we stage a demonstration and get ourselves arrested.
The first time I did Fallout 4, I sided with the Institute.
To avoid undue attention.
I did the Brotherhood, I think.
Man, the Brotherhood is like even more racist than the fucking Institute was.
I
must confer with
my colleagues. I mean, the Brotherhood half the time they're actually fucking right. I mean, they're like, yeah, we can't let idiots get their hands on technology again, and I would tend to agree. Because look at what happens when they get their hands on it.
We both need to make inroads to the orders for my
everything.
Plan to be viable.
Well,
whichever one here
just unbelievable.
It's common that things get fucked up.
I will.
Exactly.
That's not to say that. And eventually, always fuck everything,
you'll
right?
need to share some details about this long-range
otherwise
planet.
The Brotherhood wouldn't exist. Look, I'm just a fucking racist. Can't help it.
He's just so racist.
Just because I hate all races that aren't humans.
Yeah.
You know, inside of humanity, I fucking love them. I love everyone. Outside of humanity, fuck off. None of that elvish bullshit going on here. No elvish bullshit. Yeah, I built my massive, massive solar panel farm.
Say no to elvish bullshit.
Say no to elvish bullshit. Kill all elves.
Yeah, it's pretty fucking hardline shit.
Yeah, okay. We shouldn't kill them. We should just, you know,
maim them.
Not let them do blood magic.
No, fucking blood magic every time. I know
See?
What you mean.
See? And who is it always that's doing the fucking blood magic? The fucking elves. Always. Fucking always. You know?
You're racist. You're racist.
It's true!
It is very true.
Anytime it anyone ever true, fucks yeah. anything up with blood magic, it's the fucking elves doing it.
Yeah.
Pretty
you know, oh, we're so persecuted because everyone says we use blood magic. How am I going to fix this? Let's use blood magic.
Well, that was literally a quest. In fucking
yeah.
2 is literally like, oh, we're escaped apostates and everyone's gonna say we're using blood magic, so how
oh.
do we stop them from getting us?
I mean,
oh, let's
without
use
any
blood
spoilers
magic.
Without any spoilers, just fucking wait for the end of the Jagged Age 2 because you're gonna fucking love that shit then.
If you think that's bad, just you fucking wait.
Oh man, I'm ready.
God. Oh, you are not.
I'm so ready.
You are
like,
not.
The Templars are fucking, like, trying to make everybody tranquil. Like,
well,
all the
Templars
tranquil.
Are fucking pretty bastardy, but when you get to the end of the game, you kind of see their point, honestly. You kind of see their point.
Yeah, I suppose the Templars are doing an extreme response to, like, a potential situation,
right,
and then that
potential
situation yet. Fucking happens.
Because fucking all of the issues in the entire fucking world are just apostates fucking things up.
Pretty much.
You know, maybe if the apostates calmed the fuck down, then the Templars wouldn't be so fucking bastardy.
To be honest,
but
I don't Cullen, think...
Cullen's a pretty normal guy, he's a pretty cool guy, but every time he talks to a mage, they try to kill him! Like, of course he's gonna be fucking shit scared of him. Oh, God.
I'm really enjoying it, actually.
Yeah, it's good.
The combat in 2 certainly, like, flows a lot better than in 1.
It's more
one.
Action-y. 1's is a tactics-based system.
Yeah, it's definitely tactics-y. 2 is very
and
much.
3 is, like, a mixture of tactic, action, and MMO.
Yeah.
It's a bit weird. 3's combat, I'd say it's probably the weakest of the 3, but in terms of world and story, it's pretty fun.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
I'm looking forward to getting to it, because I only hear good things about it.
Yeah, the biggest complaint is that it's basically, like, it's an offline MMO. It plays very MMO-y.
Yeah.
Fucking solar panels. I have 10 steam engines that make steam by burning coal, evaporating water. They produce 5 megawatts.
Okay.
I have 74 solar panels. They produce 4.4 megawatts.
Nice.
It's fucking insane. I have 380 megajoules of accumulator battery stored, so I think I should be able to get through the night on just accumulating.
Okay. I'm in Lion's Arch.
Nice. For
the first time. And I'm gonna go straight out of Lion's Arch. Lion's Arch is a human one, right?
Oh, it's all of the races.
Oh, right, okay.
The human one is Divinity's Reach.
Why the hell is there like a sort of race conglomerate city? Like, why is that a thing?
It's where like a bunch of last stands and stuff and fights against the dragons. And like, it used to be like a pirate place, but I can't even remember how it was made. But
blood magic. Fucking
yeah, blood magic. Yeah.
Fucking blood magic every time. Oh man. I try and sort of like, I'm sort of trying to side with the apostates, but at the same time, I'm like, you fucking morons.
Yeah, you want, like, because it feels like you should be sort of like the moral high ground is, but then the apostates fuck everything up. And you're like, guys, you're making it fucking difficult, aren't you? Like, please stop summoning demons from the underworld. It's not helping.
Yeah, but I've forced about 3 different fucking apostates to go to the circle so far.
I mean, yeah, but like my sarcastic hawk was just like, he's like fanatic hater of blood. Anytime anyone's used blood magic, he's just fucking shoving, like, everyone will be like, oh shit, yeah, you know, we understand why, and they'll all turn around and like talk about it, and they'll turn back around and my greatsword will be like implanted in their skull. I'll be like, oops, couldn't control myself. Sorry about that.
Oh man, I even told Barak to kill his brother.
Yeah,
I felt a bit bad about that, but his brother was like fucking taken over by some sort of weird demon idol thing.
Red Lyrium.
Yeah. So I don't feel too bad about it.
Yeah, that shit sets you up for 3 too. You'll see.
Yeah, I have a distinct feeling that idol is, like, not okay.
Oh, really? Really?
Yeah.
What makes you say that?
Because, well, like, there's this weird woman interrogating Barak.
Brother.
or the fact that Evero goes crazy about it and his brother tries to kill him? Which one of those things makes you think it might not be okay?
I mean, there's also the fact that there's, like, there's the weird sort of Inquisitor lady talking to Varric and, like...
Cassandra, yeah. Oh, man, yeah. Oh, you're gonna fucking love that shit. I'm not gonna say about it because it spoils.
I know she's in the third one.
She is.
Because I played like the tutorial, like the very start of the third one.
Yeah, yeah.
Before I played any of the others, it was like my first entrance into it.
Yeah. You'll fucking love the way it connects to three. I think. It's pretty good stuff.
Because two and Origins are like pretty, apart from like the start where it's like, oh, the Blight has, like, fucked over Ferelden, and there's a bunch of refugees.
Honestly, one is fairly unconnected to all.
Yeah.
It just sets up the world in the start of two. Like, two and three is where the main, like, kind of events happen, honestly.
Mm.
Like, it's a bit weird.
I mean, but... I consider a Blight to be an event, though.
Well, I mean, like, in terms of overarching storyline. The Blight doesn't really have that much to do with what's going
on. Hmm.
Like, it triggers the events of later, but, like, even in the first one, you're not saving the world as such.
Because... You're saving Ferelden.
Yeah, whereas in the third one, you are actually saving the world.
Alright, okay. Do you go to Orlais and everything? That'd be cool.
Mm-hmm. You go to Orlais, yeah. A lot of the game happens in Orlais.
Essentially France.
Yeah, literally France, yeah. And they're all stuck up assholes, exactly like you want them to be.
Nice.
So,
sounds like France to me.
Yeah.
That's not true.
Classic British racism.
Any of our French viewers, of which there's currently zero viewers, you know.
Yeah, the closest,
there.
The closest we've got is a Belgium.
Yeah.
Yeah. The token,
depends
the
of
token
English,
Belgium.
I'm very close. My English is so bad, I'm sorry.
Bad, that's fine.
Nice. Sounds
big bear fucking English and half of people in England, so...
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I don't think so, but...
you do, seriously.
Yeah. Man.
English people can't speak fucking English, that's just the rule.
Yeah,
they just cannot.
Yeah, French people can't speak French either, so... No, it's true. I'm butchering French every day. It's awful.
Yeah, but, like, quite often, the culture will just butcher its own language because it's just, they want to, you know, use shorten words and shorten sentence structure and stuff to make it just easier and stuff.
They make it disgusting.
Yeah, they make it disgusting. There's a big guy here, and I want to kill him, but there's also, like, two dead people right next to him.
Yeah,
I have a distinct feeling that he's killed them both.
Kill him.
He's a giant, literally a giant. He's called like a veteran raider pack ball or something.
Oh, murder him.
He looks like It'll a fucking fun. Badass. No, he's gonna wreck me.
Yeah, murder him, it'll be fun. Who doesn't like a spot of murder? Let's be honest.
I'm gonna hit eat, yeah. No H is there. So
yeah.
I'm gonna eat and I'm coming back later.
Alright. Okie
dokie.
Okay, nice. See you later.
I'm actually also gonna have like 10-20 minutes. So
alright, okay.
If still going,
I'm gonna be
back.
I guess I can stop the stream here, I guess. Cause
probably
as well. And then
so, yes.
we'll be back in about half an hour or something like that.
Maybe. I'll be back. Bye.
Bye. I'm just gonna get this waypoint and then I will stop the stream. And we will return. Whether or not we'll return with more, whatever this is, Guild Wars, or whether we'll sit and play something else for a bit, I do not know. But yeah, we'll see you again in about 30, 40 minutes, maybe 20 minutes, depending on how long everything takes. But yes, thank you very much for joining us, and goodbye. And I say that as I need to go over into the next window and say stop stream, bye!